Well, just like the movie based on a real-life blogger and real-life culinary icon, Julie and Julia, three Sacramento women right here, Shankari Iswaran, Eileen Thornton, and Melody Elliott Coons. I'm going to get everybody's names right here. They are eating their hearts out with 110 Jewish recipes and tradition, and we're joined by them this morning to cook latkes, right?
Right.
Now, this is the book that you guys based it on, and I'm going to just pick it up. It looks like you guys have already started cooking on this a little bit, but Marlena Spieler.
Marlena Spieler.
And she actually had this wonderful cookbook, 400 recipes, I think, in here. You guys are tackling 110, and how long is it going to take you to cook all these?
Probably till sometime this summer.
Till summer. Summer. And yeah. You're blogging about it on your individual blog, so why don't we cook some latkes right now?
All right.
So what we're going to start off with is grated potatoes. Uh-huh. So I've grated some ahead of time. And then we have this nice little mixture. So you can do this ahead of time, like
good.
What we've done. So it's matzo meal, all-purpose flour, salt, pepper. And you're going to add that here, mix it up, eggs, and that's the batter that you have right here.
For a potato pancake, so to speak.
But yeah.
It's made with the matzo meal, so that changes the
You know,
way.
As being bloggers, we just have to give it a little twist.
Okay.
So we decided a little bit of Tabasco to this.
Marlena, we forgive them.
She would do the same
would
thing.
Would she do the same thing?
Yeah.
You doctor,
you she guys was at our house last week.
Oh, so you guys were able to meet her, and you guys were able to talk to her, and you have formed a relationship with her, and she's totally in support of what you guys are doing.
Oh, yeah.
She's loving it.
Now, what made you choose this particular cookbook and these kinds of recipes?
Well, I was looking at my Jewish heritage, found a bunch of Jewish cookbooks that were my grandmother's, and I wrote to Marlena, and she wrote back, and we've been corresponding for about 3 years, and then I said, hey, I think I'll blog through this, and...
You met up with some girlfriends, and the rest is history.
Yep.
What are you doing over here, Eileen? What are you cooking? You've got some berries and some cinnamon stick.
Cranberry apple relish.
Show the camera right here, so we'll tip it towards this camera. Camera one with the light. Actually, no, camera two. Somebody tell me where the close-up is, because Eileen's got this yummy stuff in the pan here, on camera two, possibly, but there's cinnamon sticks and cranberries and diced apples in here, and would this be served on top of the latkes?
Yes, it goes with the latkes and with a little bit of the sour cream.
Oh, look, over here.
Yes.
Can you guys get close-up shots of this beautiful table? We've got the latkes, we've got sour cream, this fruit mixture. Oh, my gosh, it looks so yummy. And you can serve it with applesauce, too. So it looks like a whole feast. What's this over here?
That is a sun-dried tomato and pepper salad.
Yum. Oh.
So everything is Marlena's recipes there.
Everything.
And Mel's husband, Dave, made the challah bread there as well.
Oh, my goodness.
Dave made the challah. And that's Challah's that really red yummy. Sauce, by the way.
That.
Speaking of hot sauce,
mm-hmm.
the
this
red
one right
sauce
here?
Is called skug. And it's kind of a Jewish salsa. And
it looks just like salsa.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. So you're learning all about these different recipes. Was there any major challenge that you found in cooking a traditionally Jewish recipes?
Not really. There are some ingredients that you might be new to, but that's the whole challenge of cooking.
Going cooking down the grocery aisle.
Yeah. And that was the whole point. Absolutely. Learning a different culture and... learning to cook with these, and it's been a blast so far.
All right. Well, it smells amazing. When they came into the studio, we're just like, what do you have over there? I know Eileen Javor is going to come over here and taste some potato pancake.
Oh, good.
Well, thank you to you ladies, and you can find more information on each of their blogs, either SacramentoSpice.com, CookingSchmooking.com, or just the two of us, and we'll be right back.